In a remote part of India, the identity of millions of people is being called into question.
मैं बिल्कुल शून्य हो गया, बिल्कुल शून्य के मैं धरती 30 साल प्लस सर्विस के अध्यक्ष का सेवा गया, आज मेरे साथ ये हाल।
More than 1,000 people have been branded foreigners and sent to detention camps.
गम फड़ा फड़ा माने मुरे जो आज गए एक दिन जाना यार मते बार बसता हाँ जानी।
Prisons, which the Indian government has denied, exist.
कांग्रेस और अरबन नक्सलियों द्वारा उड़ाई गई डिटेंशन सेंटर के पाए सरासर झूठ है।
101 East investigates how millions of people risk losing their Indian citizenship. Every Monday, rain or shine, 45-year-old Halima Khatun travels 7 kilometers to her local police station in India's Assam state. Missing this appointment is not an option. Halima has lived here all her life, but the state authorities claim she's not an Indian citizen.
কইলে মানে বেরিরা কাজে লাগে জগরা লাগে কো আমলা তুম বাংলাদেশি না আসামের মানুষ সরকারের দুরিয়াত হই আমি সা কথা কই আইন আমরারে কজ বাংলাদেশি এরম বা মানে বেরিরা জগরা হসা লাগে এন্ট তোমার উরফে যাইবো উরফে কি জানি তোমার খালাস হইতো পারে সেই হিসাবে তারা কখন হাসা মিশা আল্লাহ জানে উপর আল্লাহ জানে আমি তো না জানুই বিলা গরিব মানুষ পয়সা নাই কোনো সময় কত কষ্ট করে আমি ধার করে কোনো সময় গাড়ি ভাড়া দিয়ে
The police are unhappy about our presence outside the station and tell Halima to leave. For her, this ordeal has lasted over a decade. She was arrested in 2009 on suspicion of being a foreigner.
বালহরে দেখছি না আমার শোনা এবার ফার্ম জন্ম হয়েছে শ্যানডাঙ্গর হয়েছি উত্তর ডোলে আপরা করছি আমার এই জায়গার বেদ দিছে সাড়ে সন্তান হয়েছে আমার স্বামী বাদে আমার লয়ে গেছে কয়ে দিছে ওলো মুখ মানুষটারে তুমি লই আসো তোমার পরিবারের তুমি লই আও লাগে থানার ডাকছে লয়ে গেছে নগাঁও সেন্ট্রাল জেলত হয়ে দিল 2 বছর হাইকোর্টে গা উকিল দিল উকিলে কিচ্ছু কাম করে না বরে থই দিছে বরে থই দিলে 2 বছর মান রাখছে রাহার পরে দেয়া রে কুকরাজার ডিটেনশন সেন্টার সালান দিছে এবার এই বাচ্চাটারে লইয়া এই পর্যন্ত রাখে 11 বছর 7 মাস পর্যন্ত আমার জেল খাটাইল
For 7 of those years, her young son Bulbul was with her. Outside, her husband spent the family's life savings trying to secure their release.
বহুত শাস্তি হয়েছে বেয়া বাদ দিয়ে খারাপ সালুন দিয়ে খারাপ খুব কান্দা কুটি করছি খুব শাস্তি দিছে বুঝে গেছে বলে এটা আমরা ঘর বাড়ি না কি যে না বাবা এটা কো ঘর বাড়ি না তোমার হেন তোমার ভাই আছে বাপ আছে তোমার আওলাদ দুনিয়া সব আছে হে হেন এন সরকারের দরিয়া লই আছে পুলিশে লে আমরা করতো না পরে জালে ডিসি আইসে ডিসির হাতে বুড়ি ধরছি আমি স্যার আমার বাচ্চাটার ভবিষ্যৎ নষ্ট হয়ে যাইতে আছে তার বাপ আছে ঘর আরও 3টা বাচ্চা আছে হেরা যদি বিদেশি না আমার বাচ্চা কীরকম বিদেশি ওন মানুষটাও ভালো না পয়সা দিতে গেল গেলই এই হিসাবে মনের শক্তি মানে বাচ্চা রয়েছি
ইন আর্লি 2020 হালিমা ওয়াজ গ্রান্টেড বেল বাট শি স্টিল অফিশিয়ালি কনসিডার্ড আ ফরেনার There are millions like her due to a controversial process to identify illegal migrants. The National Register of Citizens, or NRC, requires people to prove they arrived in Assam prior to March 25, 1971, the day before Bangladesh declared independence. The list has excluded 1.9 million people suspected of being foreigners. Many of them have lived in Assam for generations. Across the country, people took to the streets in protest against the government's attempts to change citizenship rights. Mohammed Sanaullah is one of those whose name is not on the list of citizens.
और ये केस नहीं होता तो मैं बाल बच्चा के साथ अच्छा एक जीवन बिता सकता था, अच्छा मैंने अच्छा रिपुटेशन कमा सकते थे, मैं देश के लिए सेवा कर सकता था। तो वो मौका मेरे को गवा गई, मैंने बर्बाद हो गया जिंदगी। अभी इसलिए मजबूरी से करना पड़ रहा है।
For 30 years, Sanaullah served as a soldier in the Indian Army in conflict zones like Kashmir. In 2017, he retired from the army and joined the Assam police as a sub-inspector.
My duty was to foreigner trace out karna, foreigner ko mane actually jo already order ho chuka hai, judgment de chuka hai, aadmi idhar udhar phir raha hai, ghum raha hai.
He would interrogate these people and sometimes escort them to prisons designated as detention camps. He had no idea that the state was building a case against him.
मेरे को मैंने डिटेंशन सेंटर में भेजेगा ही भेजेगा, अभी कोई ऑप्शन नहीं है। छुपा जाऊंगा या लुका के रहूंगा तो मैंने आगे और बड़ा इशू हो जाएगा। जिस दिन मेरे को मैंने थाने में लिया शाम का टाइम पे, तो उस दिन तो आउट टूट पड़ा।
अनलाइक मोस्ट डिटेनीज, ही वाज एबल टू पे बेल ऑफ $275 एंड वाज रिलीज्ड आफ्टर अ वीक, बट एज फार एज द स्टेट इज कंसर्न्ड, he is a foreigner living illegally in India.
वो बोलते हैं आप foreigner हैं, लेकिन आप इस गांव में आपको सब जानते हैं, तो आपको कैसा लगता है जब आप इधर आते हो?
बहुत ही बहुत खराब लगता है, बहुत ही बहुत शॉक लगता है कि दुखी की बात है कि मैं इस गांव में पैदा होते हुए भी ये मेरा जमीन है, ये धरती गांव ही देगा, छक ही देगा। अगर ये बोलेगा तुम विदेशी है। बचपन से मेरा बहुत कुछ याद है। मेरा बड़ा भाई था, उसके साथ में खेलते थे, लुका छुका खेलते, लुका फको खेलते थे। हाँ, उसके बाद मेरा पिताजी से खेत में काम करते थे, उसके लिए नाश्ता बने लेके आते थे सुबह सुबह, जैसे 8-9 बज गया मैं स्कूल में चला जाता था। हाँ, ये मेरा स्कूल है, ये मैं बचपन से यहाँ इस स्कूल में पढ़ता था, ये मेरा क्लास रूम था, ये यहाँ से मैं क्लास 1-5 तक पढ़ाई किया।
1-5
That was the yeah, उस समय मेरा एज 6 या 7 years का था।
Sanaullah says he was born in this village in 1967, qualifying him as an Indian citizen. But he claims that local authorities did not visit here to inquire about his past before declaring him a foreigner. For him, the NRC process contradicts the very values that once embodied secular India.
बिल्कुल ऑपोजिट है। गांधी का जो आदेश, उसका जो भावना थी उस टाइम का, तो उसका भी बरखिलाफ है उसका। उसका मैंने जो आदेश वगैरह था, अनेक कम है एक को बोलते हैं, बहुत सारा भाषा भाषी के बीच में एक हिंदुस्तान, ऐसा नहीं है। अभी ही मैंने पॉलिटिक्स में देख लो जात पात का हो गया।
Mohammad Sanaullah's case is well known across India and has become a sort of litmus test for the efficiency of the NRC exercise. With many people asking that if a man who served for 30 years in the Indian Army doesn't get to call himself a citizen, then really who does? The requirement to prove their citizenship has been difficult or impossible for many. No one is sure what will happen to those who are unable to prove their identity, but a clue may lie in a remote site in Mathia, in Lower Assam. So we're coming up to this detention center on our left here. Now, it's still under construction, but when it's ready, it will be the country's largest detention center. We're going to go in. We'll see if they let us go in or not. Lawyer Abonti Datta is fighting to improve conditions for those who have been excluded from the list and are in detention.
International law says that if you have to detain someone, there has to be imminent threat and it has to be immediate. You can only detain someone for a very short duration of time before they're deported. Bangladesh is not willing to accept the community of people we call for non-citizens.
And so they may well end up here, a new detention center built at a cost of $6.4 million spread over 6.5 acres. A few years ago, Abonti and her team were on a routine visit to offer legal aid in a state prison when they discovered something interesting.
Civil society didn't know about the fact that there were these, what we call them declared foreign nationals being housed in the correctional spaces. We came across this constituency, this community of people whose citizenship status was in question. So it was revealed to us that the correctional spaces, six of the correctional spaces were designated as detention centers. Between 2009 to 2017, it was the best kept secret in Assam.
In late 2020, acting on a petition from Abonti's team and human rights groups, the state high court ruled that suspected foreigners cannot be held inside existing prisons. For the government, it's now more urgent than ever to complete this detention center.
Oh, ये तो किहोर करने बनाए से जाने नहीं के।
हमने detainee भी लगवा रहे हैं।
Detainee मैंने कौन बोल detainee?
भी लग थोड़ा खेरी हमने इसमें detainee नहीं था ना। हाँ। Detainee
भी लगवा करने। Detainee करने बनाए से।
Is it like some of the prisons you've had a chance to visit?
No. It's very different. It's completely different. This is very stark. You know, because when you go to the correctional homes, it doesn't feel like you're going into a correctional home. It's really like a village environment. This is like really like an industrial complex.
State authorities have outlined a plan to build 10 more detention camps like this one. For the millions excluded from the list, the National Register of Citizens has destroyed their lives. But some politicians like Sheila Ditya Dev, a member of Prime Minister Modi's Hindu nationalist BJP party, have gained notoriety by capitalizing on the citizenship debate.
So, I mean, construction started before this, or no?
Today, we join him as he campaigns for re-election to the state's legislative assembly. He represents Hojai, a district that has one of the highest rates of exclusion from the citizenship list. He has consistently used the citizenship issue to target Assam's Muslim community, who account for over 34% of the state's total population.
Today, more than 11 districts are 100% Muslim dominated districts. They always try to hurt the sentiment of the Hindu. They are not citizens. So now they are trying to grab power through different means. Different type of jihadis is going on. Jihadi activities are going on. Whether it's love jihad, yes.
What is love jihad actually?
Through Facebook. Anybody can get into any place. So this Muslim boys who are well trained, they trap the Hindu girls by fake names. At times they even kill them.
There's absolutely no evidence to back his claim that Muslim boys are trained to kill Hindu girls.
This is, see, they're selling beef here. This red cloth indicates that they're selling beef here. This red cloth. This is a Muslim area. Because you know that selling beef is illegal.
In fact, while the sale and consumption of cow meat is indeed banned in many parts of India, it is still legal in Assam. At several campaign stops along the way, Sheila Ditya continues to openly disparage the Muslim community.
কালকে যদি এই দেশের পপুলেশন 60% যদি মুসলিম হয়ে যায় এই দেশ কি সেকুলার হয়ে থাকবে এটা তো ইসলাম দেশ হয়ে যাবে ইসলামিক কান্ট্রি হয়ে যাবে তাইজন্য হিন্দু আছে বলেই এই দেশ সেকুলার হয়ে আছে আমরা যদি এই ব্যাপারে যদি চিন্তা ভাবনা না করি আমরা এনআরসির ব্যাপারে যদি না ভাবি আমরা ডি ভোটারের কথা যদি না বলি আমরা কা রুলস এসছে কিনা ওই ব্যাপারে যদি আমরা না ধরি তাহলে তো হিন্দু সমাজের মুশকিল আছে আর হিন্দু সমাজ যদি ভেঙে পড়ে তো বিজেপির জেতার কোনো চান্স নেই
At each campaign stop, he repeats a version of the same message, that Muslim citizens are unwelcome and potentially dangerous intruders. For him, the National Register of Citizens is fundamentally flawed because it did not go far enough in identifying suspected foreigners.
Even in the Parliament of India, when there were questions and answers, we have heard about 40 lakhs, 50 lakhs foreigners staying in Assam. But when the NRC results came in, we saw that it was 19 lakhs something, almost 20 lakhs. So where are those foreigners gone? You have to stop giving government benefits to the foreigners. You have to defranchise them. You have to ensure that they don't get into the political system, they don't get into the Indian Army, they don't get into any of the forces, and they don't become a national threat. But they can remain here because they have already entered and no country is going to take them away and you can't kill them. So we have to live with them, but then they should not snatch our rights.
Those excluded from the list can appeal to specially formed courts called foreigners' tribunals. But the COVID-19 pandemic brought the process to a screeching halt in March 2020, leaving 1.9 million people in limbo. These tribunals have already declared that Halima and Mohammed Sanaullah are foreigners. Sanaullah has petitioned to the High Court to review his case.
We have a list in 1966, which is my father's name.
अच्छा और ये डॉक्यूमेंट एक्सेप्टेड है
ना हाँ एक्सेप्टेड है जी
तो आपके फादर का नाम
मोहम्मद अली सन ऑफ सेटू 1931 का मुताबिक ये मेरा पिताजी का नाम भी है ये जो 1931 में रिवेन्यू होता है जमीन अलॉटमेंट हाँ आधार कार्ड है हाँ
पासपोर्ट
भी दिखा सकते हो आपको
For many, the consequences of these minor bureaucratic errors can be enormous. Sanaullah's entire life now depends on these pieces of paper.
तो दूसरे का दुख अभी भी समझ सकता हूँ जो कि जीनियन इंडियन है जो उसका वैलिड डॉक्यूमेंट है वैलिड कागज कागजात अब ये क्यों नहीं मानते हो जिसका फादर इंडियन है लड़का कैसे हो सकता है फॉरेनर मैं गर्व से बोल सकता हूँ मैं इंडियन हूँ गर्व से बोलूँगा मेरा जन्म इधर है मरूंगा इधर ही धरती में ही मरूंगा मैं बांग्लादेश में थोड़ी मरूंगा
In the state capital, Guwahati, Obonti is meeting her team of lawyers and communication specialists to discuss the new detention camp under construction.
Is this a site for further conflict? Is really, really the question that was very, very troublesome for me, you know.
Are they actually planning to bring all the detainees from, you know, all over Assam and put them there? Or, like, what is the plan?
Actually, I really recommend that the team must go to Mattia, like, immediately. But I also think it should be just not just a strategic litigation, because we should really also write about this, you know. We should really also document it other ways.
While they discuss strategies, the team remains focused on a more important task: ensuring that those excluded from the National Register of Citizens receive free legal aid.
The stories that move me most are how it affects the women, because, you know, women, rural women, when they are married off, they're normally married off to villages that are far away from their parental homes. You don't have the particular documents that the NRC process required. And so a lot of women got impacted.
Today, Abonthi is meeting a possible new client, Halima, who we met earlier during her weekly visit to the police station.
Namaskar, namaskar. How are you? My name is Abonthi. I'm from Guwahati. I'm Anubhav. I've been talking to you a lot. I've been talking to you a lot. I've been talking to you. আৰু জেলৰ পৰিস্থিতিটো কেনেকুৱা আছিলে?
তাৰপিছত ইমান ইমান জাগা চিবা চিবা জাগা, এই জাগাৰ মাজে ল'ৰা কাপোৰ দিয়ে বান্ধি থৈ দিছোঁ হাতে ভৰি। বেলেগৰ আনৰ জাগাত গ'লে বুটল ফালাই দিব পানীৰ, কোনোবা থাল ফালাই দিব, কোনোবা কি কৰিব, দুষ্ট কৰিব, সিহঁতে মাৰিব।
Over the years, Halima's family sold their farm and spent nearly $7,000 on lawyers in a bid to prove her and her son's citizenship and secure their release. But none of the lawyers could ever explain to her why their identity was being questioned.
Ar mur bap ma koka deta sob keta gorot tar pora moi okol bangladeshi ar iar pora mul lora bangladeshi etu kotha hol naki na badu ek istuki basi singbar lagya byabostha korbar parbo naki.
পিছে এটা উপায় এনে ক'ব পাৰি যে এনেকুৱা ধৰণৰ গণ্ডগোল হৈছে, আপোনালোকক কাগজ পাতি দিয়া নাই, উকিলৰ মানে ভালকৈ আপোনালোকক হেৰি কৰিব পৰা নাই, সেইকাৰণে সেনেকুৱা কৰি পেলাই এটা সুপ্ৰিম কোৰ্টত এটা ট্ৰাই কৰিব পৰা যায়, সেইটো এটা আছে, সেইটো এটা উপায় এটা আছে। আৰু সেইটোত আমি
Abonthi has decided to take Halima on as a client.
এটা লিখি দিব। I think there were a lot of procedural errors there. She hasn't managed to get adequate legal representation. I mean, from the papers, it appears that she could be a citizen of India, because this is clearly a miscarriage of justice. There is a possible chance that we may just get a review. Otherwise, the risk of her being deported to Bangladesh is still very alive.
Halima is finally allowing herself to think about the future. She wants to make up for lost time and focus on her son Bulbul's education.
কিবা একটা আমার আগবাড়াইতে পারবো, মানে এটা আমার মনে একটু বিশেষ আইসে আর কি।
For Halima, Sanaullah and millions of others, there are no quick solutions. They are likely to spend many years untangling themselves from the complex process that has left them effectively stateless, with no country to call home.